Welcome to a factory AI environment. In this environment, we have a pick and place control using this robotic arm. Now we have two conveyors. We are having some objects coming on this conveyor. The objective is to pick the lid and place it on the clamp, place it on the cover, and it will make a joint and it will pass from this conveyor. So this is very simple. Now we have, let's look at the panel first. We have an emergency stop, start, reset, stop, auto manual selection button, and the counter which will display the number of boxes being processed and completed. So here we have, this is the emitter. Here we are gonna have some objects. This is a base clamper in which will align the objects. You will see in the application, this is again to align the object. It can also move up and down. This is pick and place gantry. Here we have a Z motion, we have an X motion, and here we have a small gripper which is pneumatically actuated. So let's start this process. So initially I go to play, and here this is an automatic process. So in the panel I will go to auto, and then I'll press start. So let me just align the camera so that you can see what's going on. So when I press start, you can see that these objects are already here. When I press start, the conveyor starts running, and then you have a clamper like this. It will go up, it will pass. Now it will align the objects, it will come down, hold the object, go forward, place the object, it will move up, and it will move down. And this will keep on going. It is irrespective of the color, you can still get the object placed there. So this is about how you can do pick and place operation in factory IO. And this is just to remind you, this design has been made from the libraries. You can also design your own pick and place. You can have 2-3 more gantries. You can place it here or another conveyor. That's how you can do that. And we have added a counter which will display the number of boxes being produced. This you can also reset using this reset button. It goes to zero, just in case if you want. Now we have a stop button. The stop button will stop the loop. Alright, so suppose let this pick this object. Now I press stop. Now it will place the object and it will not give me another object now. And now the cycle will stop. Now again when I press start, it will resume doing what it was doing before. Okay, so this is how you can design a logic and make your FPD more flexible by including start, stop or reset operation. Alright, thank you for watching. I hope you find this environment very interesting. Thank you.